Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to The Edit Place. And today we're taking a look at how to get the ProMist filter look for free. So this video clip right here has the ProMist look to it. It's got the kind of bloomed highlights and a little bit of glow on me. And this is a shot with the filter removed. If you have no idea what a ProMist filter is, so it's basically what looks like a clear filter, but it has some textures on it that when placed in front of a light source or kind of it interacts with light, it adds more of a kind of glowy bloomed highlight look, very dreamy, very soft. Now, for those of you who know about ProMist, you may have caught that this isn't actually an official ProMist filter. The reason I use that term is because most people have heard of ProMist. They kind of know what that filter does. And so this actually is a very good competitor to the official ProMist. This is made by Prism FX, Prism Lens FX, and it is called the Dream FX filter, which you can find linked down below. Literally costs like a fourth of what the ProMist does and is very high quality glass. I've used this on a lot of projects. It's seriously really good piece of equipment for a lot cheaper. Now, for those of you curious, ProMist comes in various different strengths, and I've heard that the Dream FX is, some people say it's about an eighth or a fourth. So let's get started here in this easy little tutorial. Again, I have my clip here with the filter physically on and here without, same exact aperture, lighting, everything's the same. First, we are going to go to our color page and our clips here. I do have a third clip actually, where I had the filter placed in front of the lens halfway. So this side is ProMist turned on and this is turned off. First thing I want to do is just add kind of a Rec 709 look to everything. So I'm just going to apply the Blackmagic Gen 5 look to extended video. And then I'm kind of just going to balance this real quick. Alrighty, don't want to do too much to it, but that looks good. So I'm just going to grab a still of that and quickly apply it to both of the other clips so that they're all the same. So again, this is our ProMist and this is with it out. Definitely adds a kind of a haze over my face coming from my key light as well. So it's definitely still more dreamy and you can definitely see the contrast there. Obviously I just have one light source, so this of course is brighter than this side of the face, but you can also see just much sharper on this side here. Now, by the way, I am actually using the free version of DaVinci Resolve. So when I say in the title how to do the ProMist look for free, you can't even comment like, oh, well, you need DaVinci Resolve Studio. Nope. We're actually going to do this all for free right here. So let's go to our clip that doesn't have the filter on. And I'm just going to add a new node here. And you're going to open your open effects panel if you don't already. So that's that guy right there. You can toggle it on and off. And under the Resolve FX Lite, what's nice is a lot of this stuff is restricted for the studio. So aperture diffraction, we get this lovely thing that pops up if you don't have the studio version. But what we're going to use is the glow, which is free. And you can see what it's already done in there. It's basically just added a glow to everything. Biggest slider over here that you really want to mess around with, depending on the strength of the image that you want, is this shine threshold. So obviously all the way to the left is going to be ultra powerful and all the way to the right is going to be pretty minimal. Check out any of these. So shiny regions, for example, this one will limit just to really the highlighted areas. Rather than just doing the glow and get some pretty abstract stuff going, but we're gonna go for the glowing image and you can kind of just play around with everything. Again, this is the spread. So I wanna bring the brightness down because I don't wanna clip. You can see on my scopes in the bottom right there that before I was clipping, so I wanna bring that information back and I gotta turn up the brightness a little bit here. to actually make the glow noticeable, I guess. Play around with this. I'm actually going to go back to my other node, see if I can help it by lowering my brightness here. And that way I can still add that glow. There we go. If I toggle this node on and off, you can see it's definitely adding a glow. And you can see on the actual ProMist filter here, you can see on the edges, it kind of extends the highlight bloom there, so it gets rid of the vignette a bit. Pair these side by side. So we can see that the ProMist filter one almost added a little bit of a greenish tint, it looks like. Just a little bit. Change the skin tones a tad. That's very interesting to look at, but for the most part, it's getting pretty much there. Right around there is pretty good. Yeah, that's a nice little glow there. Pretty simple. So there you guys have it. That is basically how you get the ProMist look for free. Now, why would you want to do this? Obviously, one would be if you can afford a ProMist filter, but also the other advantage is when you shoot with a filter on your lens, it is permanent, right? It's baked into the image because you're actually shooting through another piece of glass. And so let's say in post, you don't want that dreamy look anymore. And there's only so much you can do to fix that. Whereas since we shot this one normally, I can always go in, turn off that glow and create a whole different look, make really sharp and gritty if I wanted to, or I can go back and adjust how much glow I wanted. So there are advantages and disadvantages to doing things in post versus actually on set. So hopefully this video helped you guys out. If you're not subscribed already, definitely would appreciate it if you hit that good little red button right down there, and check out all the links in the description for everything featured in this video. See you guys in the next video.